that's a lot of boobs. In July of 2015, we were training on some new equipment, and we had a list of patients, test patients, and we needed a few more, so I thought, might as well volunteer. I had missed my mammogram in February, like a lot of us do, and I thought I might as well just get it out of the way. So the radiologist looks at my mammogram and he's like, you know what? We need some additional pictures. So I thought, we call back patients every day for more pictures and think of it really. And we do that, and he said, you know what? Let's do an ultrasound. Again, we do that every day. Call patients back every day for an ultrasound after the mammogram. Didn't really worry about it. After the ultrasound, he's like, we're going to have to schedule a biopsy. Okay, a little bit worried. So we do the biopsy, and he said, I'll give you a call. We'll let you know what the results are. So he gives me a call back, and he said, you know, cancer. Go figure. I've been doing mammograms for 20 years, and I thought never. I would never get cancer. But yeah, that was an eye-opening experience, and I thought, okay, well, we're gonna have to start somewhere. So after the diagnosis, I was set up with the Lemon Holton building, and I was set in front of a panel of doctors, surgeons, and we discussed the beginning to the end of the diagnosis of what the whole process would be. That was a pretty overwhelming day. It was an all day. Mom went with me. And after we did that, we decided, okay, first step was gonna be chemo. And the chemotherapy, I didn't think it was gonna be scary, but the not knowing what to expect. You hear patients say how they get sick every day, and I dealt well with it. I was able to do everyday things, go to work, take care of the kids, but I didn't feel great. And after the chemo began, hair was gonna start to fall out. So little bits by little bits came out, handfuls and then handfuls. And I told the kids, I'm like, well, I thought that was probably the most hard part of it all was, what are the kids gonna think? How are they gonna handle it? So I thought, what would be the easiest thing? Let's just shave mom's head. That would be the easiest thing. How fun is that? So after everything started falling out, okay, there's the shaver. The kids went to town and cut my hair, and believe it or not, that's like probably like the fondest memories of the whole cancer process. We had a really good time with that. I know you didn't think so, Mom, but it was fun. And after chemo was done, surgery was still gonna happen. I thought that we wouldn't have to, because after chemo was done, they thought, oh, your masses are gone. I was like, great. I thought we were gonna have to do surgery, but we still had to. And I thought, what am I gonna do? The surgeon said, we're gonna do a partial mastectomy. And I thought, who is gonna want this after that? And I've seen partial mastectomies, I've seen mastectomies and reconstruction, and I thought, it's not pretty for the most part. But after I had the surgery, we had reconstruction immediately following that. And I was not wanting to look at myself for a while, but thinking, you know, I'm gonna look like Frankenstein's bride, all pieced back together. But after a week or so, I realized I have one more surgery to go, and this is not the final product. And I finished everything, and I've started to feel normal again. And I think back in July, and I'm like, oh, I can reschedule that mammogram. Or it's not really a priority. I have better things to do. And I'm not going to be that one out of eight women who gets breast cancer. But really, out of that 78,000 mammograms, that's the one mammogram that saved my life.
Sweats and you know, you're hot, you're cold, maybe you're a little moody sometimes, you know, skin changes. But there's also a very large emotional component to that. And so again, we have another story. Cindy Warren is a mother.
Journeys and make people feel that they're not alone. And knowing where you are and what you're doing. And it's not fancy, it's not new. It's something that we already do, but it's practicing that skill and getting better at it. My personal experience with mindfulness is back from 2001. It was at a time when there was a lot of things going on. It was 9/11, there was a lot of unrest, but there was tickets to this presentation at the Forum Thaw in Muskegon to see Deepak Chopra. And my mom was a fan. And I thought, wow, this is great. I'm gonna buy these tickets, I'm gonna surprise her. And I was interested in what he had talked about. We had his book, Perfect Health. And so we bought the tickets and we went to the